Hand loaders, bullet casters, welcome back to my bench. Welcome back to this series on bullet path, especially how it pertains to cast. As you can see, I have a revolver in front of me, and we are focusing on some of these little important areas of the revolver as it pertains to the flight of the bullet from the time that primer strikes to the time that bullet leaves the barrel. Now, we have been focusing a lot on the throat, and just recently we have spent a good little bit of time on the barrel cylinder gap. Now, I have something for us here today, and it pertains to the forcing cone, because this is where we're going next, folks. We're about to dive right through the forcing cone. I have here a kit called the Lewis Lead Remover. It's a great tool. It works great if you're having some serious leading problems, but we're going to be applying it for a different purpose today. I also have here this little can of Mother's Aluminum Wheel Polish and this little tube of valve grinding compound. Yeah, I know, that's, you know, rebuilding engine type stuff, but sometimes we find use for it in other areas too. So once again here, I've got my Ruger GP100 chalked up in this big orange mean vise, and I am trying to show you a good picture of my forcing cone. Now, it's cut pretty well. I'm real happy with the cut. However, there is something that I'm not too particularly fond of, and it's the roughness of it. Let me bring you in on that. There are a lot of tool marks in that forcing cone. Now, the gun shoots great, folks. I'm absolutely happy with it. The only thing that I'm not really happy with is the fact that after I do shoot it, I do get a little bit of lead deposit built up in that forcing cone. And it used to be a whole lot worse. So I'm really happy with how it is now. However, I would like to clean it up a little bit. I would like to see those lead deposits go away. And one thing to note here, based on our discussion, is this bullet that I'm showing you. If you look at that shoulder, that is one sharp shoulder. There is just no wiggle room for alignment problems with this gun. Can you imagine how bad that lead would be if it was hitting right here on the side every time, as opposed to maybe something that's a round nose that could probably transition a little bit better? So the benefits of the 11 degree and the cast bullet, I think based off of what I've shown you here, are quite obvious. What matters most is how well is your chamber lined up to the barrel, because that is what's going to dictate how much of a forcing cone issue you really have. Folks, on the topic of how well is my cylinder aligned to my barrel, you know, like I said, sometimes not so much, and we really depend on a good forcing cone to help us in those situations. But there is something that I notice a lot of revolver guys struggling to understand, and what it is the side-to-side play in their cylinder. I'm going to show you here, first, as you'd probably like to see, the gun is unloaded. So I am about to fool with the trigger. Now, when I pull this hammer back, and I note I've got this play here, well, that's not a bad thing, folks. A lot of people kind of turn their nose up at it. Now, some revolvers, you're going to find that they lock up further once that trigger has been depressed. These Rugers, not quite so much. That play is still there. So what's going to happen is with that primer struck, that play is still occurring. Now, a lot of people will turn their nose up to this play because it's going to tell them, oh, hey, this revolver is not built as tight as it ought to be. This revolver has problems. That's not necessarily the case. You see, if we don't have that play there, and we can have further problems whenever that bullet transitions over into that forcing cone. Because if the chamber is not lined up 100% perfect, then it's going to go off crooked. The bullet is going to travel crooked to make it into that forcing cone. With the play that we have in this cylinder, that can allow for the cylinder to kick in the direction that it needs once the base of the bullet is beginning to leave the chamber. It's kind of a self-correcting concept. How well it works, I don't know because I haven't really tested the matter. However, common wisdom ought to let you know that this can help in those situations where you do have a little bit of an alignment problem from the chamber to the barrel. We can't assume it's 100%. If it was 100% aligned, that play can be taken out. But if it's not, folks, leave that play there. So folks, what I'm hoping to depict for you right here in this shot, let's see if we can get a little light on it, is the forcing cone in my vise. What I am going to do is polish it up. I'm going to see if we can remove some of those pesky little tool marks that I was telling you about. Now what I have here is this Lewis lead remover kit, and it works great for removing lead. If you're having some problems with the revolver that just leads up, maybe you've been trying to get to the bottom of it, you get out there, you try something with your load or your bullet hardness or something, and you experiment, and you're just not having much luck, and it's a nightmare cleaning it out. This kit right here is great. It uses these little brass screens that will draw the lead out of the lands and grooves using this little doodad right here. And it also has this forcing cone cleaner that it wraps around as well, and it does a great job cleaning up the forcing cone. But my forcing cone is clean. I don't have a lead problem there. And what I want to do here is I want to use this tool to put a nice polish on that forcing cone and to see if I can get rid of some of those tool marks. Now, if you just take you a patch after you've already used your tool to clean out the lead with that screen still on it, you just take you a patch, you poke you a hole in there, and we're gonna run this little patch, this cotton patch, right over that screen. Now, I'm gonna use valve grind compound for my initial start. This stuff, folks, it's pretty aggressive. It will remove metal. So we don't need to get carried away with it. We can do a little bit of harm if we're not careful. This stuff is used to recondition valves in the automotive field, and it's got, an array of good uses. It kind of lays on just like any other type of polishing agent that you might use. And the toolkit itself is aluminum, so you don't have to worry so much about scratching up your steel barrel with steel on steel contact. This stuff, it gets on the fingers real thick, and it can get everywhere easily. So have some rags handy so that there you go, so that you can clean up. We don't want to get this stuff all over the place. We don't want it traveling around in the action of our firearm. And It's real simple. We'll put this in first, and then we will attach the tool to it, and you're going to see exactly what kind of results we get. So here it is, folks. We're going to do it. Now, I can't sit here and tell you that I've done this many, many times before. So I'm also doing a little bit of experimenting. And I am quite confident that this is going to work out really well. If it doesn't, folks, who can I blame but myself? And I want you to see the results here, because there is just no way for this to turn out but good. We're going to have a nice polish. See how it's spinning it around? Now, if I did not have, I got to tell you, I did practice on another gun, but I haven't shot it yet. And what I did find out is if I didn't have that little copper screen on that forcing cone adapter, then, you know, the cloth would just kind of separate it. It wouldn't spin. Now, I've got several good turns on here already. There was some roughness, but now I'm starting to feel it kind of smooth out. So I'm thinking at this point, yeah, I might go ahead and stop and just check my work. Let's see here. I might need to use, this stuff is nasty, folks. It'll get everywhere. Make sure you do a good cleanup before you even think about firing this firearm. Or your firearm. You're not firing mine. Sorry, guys. Because this valve grind compound does exactly what it says it will do. It will grind. Now, it's probably going to look pretty nasty in there because of that compound. However, I will say, it does look like we have removed pretty good bit of that. I might actually want to do another pass. Just one more pass. But I don't think so. This bullet is seated in there just a little bit further. What I might do is just go ahead and clean it up. I'm going to clean it up with some oil, just regular gun oil. I'm going to run a few patches through it. I'm going to make sure I get all that nastiness off. Then what I'm going to do is a polish with that fine Mother's Aluminum Wheel Polish.